Good morning to all of you. I am Rajiv Sharma. I will be presenting, discussing some points. We have seen the government policies, state government level and central government level policies, very aggressive, very positive note from all the angles. Government is formulating policy, industries are coming up forward and they are joining hands to government and implementing policies. Results we can see, whatever government decided and industries able to deliver it. And now comes to sustainability and performance. But there's a great challenge now, as Professor Singh Sir was telling, that tariff has gone down, solar 2.42, wind is 3.46. Now, is it sustainable or further there's a chance of further reduction that we need to consider? First of all, these plants which are being awarded 2.42, this is yet to perform. So this are whatever we are discussing, numbers is fine, but at least whatever model we are procuring, what we are implementing, it should be sustainable, it should be workable to the government, to the industry both, because both has to join together, government agencies plus industries, to make this system implementable and workable. Without this support is not possible, because now we are putting a lot of plants in solar, wind, all across, aggressive plants. But parallelly, infrastructure has to be developed for grid connectivity, creation of load. Sometimes we face problem, you have to shut down your plants because we don't need your load, we don't need power. So the number which are aggressive numbers are put in by the industries to get the bidding numbers, these all they are not considered, that my plant will be shut down for so many days or so many hours in a day. That has to be considered by the government agencies also. Because these plants are very, very optimistic and optimized level. To sustain this performance has to maintain, plants to be operated at peak level. So infrastructure creation at the state level, central level, that has to be in place. So plants are performing. This is the main target of government and industry, both are there, plants should be performing. And what our number, we IRR number, what we have decided during the all calculations, during our all workings, this should work on at the ground level also. I represent Maitra Energy. We are operating currently 1.01 gigawatt wind power, and we are developing 480 megawatt solar plants. Currently 60 megawatt we have commissioned in Punjab and almost 50 megawatt in Telangana. Remaining plants are under commissioning and final stage of commissioning. See, like geography of the things I was telling, it's a fact, because we can generate, we are the second country in the worldwide, we are blessed with the sun power worldwide. India is getting solar index 64, other than USA. So we have many sunny days compared to all worldwide. In 365 days, we have 300 sunny days in India average, all across. So this is a high number of sunny days we have generation is available to us from solar power. And this only Rajasthan state, if you implement solar power, what barren land, what we have, it can create up to 750 gigawatt power only from one state. That potential we have in India. So solar power has huge potential, there's no doubt. Only thing is that we have to work together, ensure this industry is growing, sustaining and performing its achievements. So currently this what Singh Sir telling, this number is almost 50,000 unit from 50,000 megawatt from renewable energy, which has increased to 57. Correct, because every day, every month we are adding some power. So our target for wind this year may not be achieved because bidding process started, so it will be slightly delayed current year, but next year wind also will pick up just like solar. But this year solar doing very well, a lot of biddings are coming, SECI bid, state bids, a lot of bids are coming, people are participating and being implemented. You can see the growth of solar energy. Last year was 16 was very fantastic year for growth for everybody. All participated state-wise, central policy, state policy, due to all support, industry support, growth is very, very high. And this year expected better than last year performance. So like 2022 target for 100 gigawatt is achievable, no doubt. And one more thing, today we came to another 20,000 megawatt shifted from rooftop to grid connected. It's a good news for solar park. developers, because rooftops certainly, because the number of quantities are very quantities more, but megawatt installed is very less. So these are distributed. But solar parks are being developed by the state government or central government is a very good idea, no doubt, because infrastructure cost is shared, which is sustainable. So a lot of disturbances in the operating plant, for example, load sharing activities or any local issues or your operating cost, that is optimized. So that helps in sustaining your plant performance. See, these are some of the steps which we are putting a lot of plants and scattered and all across the rural area, somewhere solar park. Our exposure is everywhere in the market, correct? Because earlier solar plant was there with 5 megawatt, 10 megawatt, now we have 50 megawatt, 100 megawatt, or solar park, 500 megawatt, 1 gigawatt. So size increasing. So we have exposure to other societies, villages, nearby villages, near town. We have exposure. So that need to be maintained properly. Relation need to be built up. And that is required to operate your plant in good environment. Because if you don't maintain good relations ultimately with the society, with government, or with the local authorities, then we are going to be suffer in a lot. So while all these things, like we have 3 points which plant could be able to sustain. One is government policy, which are already in place. Second, execution of the plant, which are happening very good way. People are executing plant in good way. People are maintaining also. Maintaining is the second part. If you are not able to maintain your plant as per your performance parameters, then whatever number you have proposed, whatever number you are delivering, it may not match your expectation or your returns. So to ensure that your plants are performing better what you have expected, for that you need a good quality contractors, those who can deliver performance, not only just cleaning module. There are many things need to be done. Technical evaluation has to be done. Plant efficiency need to be improved, either through thermography, through drone inspection, or the module degradation, or a monitoring system. It should be such that you should be able to add some value day by day. Every day you are generating something extra. Then you are doing some effective O&M. Not only O&M, we have to very efficient O&M we have to plan. For that we need to shortlist a contractor who can do good job for you. Not rate of the contractor, because we can get many contractors, very few numbers, hardly 10-15% difference. But year quantum, what difference you get, maybe 30-40%, you can't imagine also. So these are some maintenance, this is dumb, all companies are doing the predefined maintenance recommended by the inverter suppliers, module suppliers. So people are doing this, and monitoring is the remote monitoring done through mobile applications. A lot of IT tools are available to monitor the performance. That need to be done properly, professionally. Even person, some industry entered the solar market, but they may not be aware very much what is solar in out. But for them, the tools are available for them. For solar, mobile tools are mobile applications available. SCADA softwares are available in the market. So please have close look on that particular asset what you invested. That is for 25 years. It's not for 1 year or 2 years. So remember that to perform 25 years, you should have reliable equipment supplier, reliable O&M supplier, and reliable performance monitoring system. And some compliances we have to make, some EHS compliances. Pollution, whatever compliance required, there is a laid down that need to be done. Because if you are not complying anything at the plant level, then long term going to be effective in your plant performance. So we ensure all compliances, let it be labor law or minimum wages or your performance reporting to the IREDA or any other government agencies should be proper and in time, including our invoicing billing. There's something which we have complete plant can be thermographed with your drone inspection through thermography cameras. So you can identify which area of your modules or strings are not working. So once you identify, you can take some corrective action. So how you can maintain your performance? Because solar ultimately is a stationary plant, nothing is moving. Just you have to monitor and identify any non-generating part that has to be replaced. Just to identify non-generating part, you should use technology. So drone inspection or thermography camera, many things are, experts are available. So please make use of that and rest assured, whatever money you are spending on this all predictive maintenance, this payback is few days only. Remaining days you are getting benefit out of that. So this we can identify all any hot spot, any abnormality observed, even the temperature variation. So the corrective action can be taken. See, electrical, the complete electrical system, the advantage of electrical system is that identification is difficult. Once you identify, rectification is easy. Once you identify which module not working, which my contractor not working, which panel not working, you can go to replacement. But to identify that, that is a major task. So you need to work on that, how to identify the fault as fast as possible, as quick as possible, just to improve the efficiency. And these are those who are manufacturers are coming, a lot of suppliers are coming. So the relationship has to be very strong relationship. It should not happen that after equipment supply, people are not responding. This is a long-term relationship. Ultimately, we are looking for all equipment suppliers, which are either imported or local levels. So while placing your order, while procuring your equipment, please ensure long-term assurance is given to you and how you are safeguarding your interests. Because ultimately, the equipment, you are not getting any support, either in warranty or out of warranty, then where you will go. So there shall be additional cost which need to be taken care. So this, while deciding this, not only price of the equipment, this is the reliability and the service support of the equipment, because this plant going to run for 25 years, not for up to commissioning only. And this has to perform your IRR number also. If returns are not coming, ultimately the plant which you have performed is going to be non-performing asset after 5 years or 6 years. Then you say, this, my policy was not gone, somebody had done some mistake, but ultimately there's a series of mistakes which people are tend to happen to, they can do. So try to avoid it. Try to target for long term. These are 25-year life of the plant. It's not 5 year, 2 year, 3 year. A government policy is very clear. Water plant you are putting, your PLF is freezed, upper also, lower. Between that you have to operate. If you're operating lower the PLF, again there's a penalty. Correct, sir? Because you have to, plant has to perform within the bandwidth. If you're not able to deliver your PLF number, what PPA signed, then there's a penalty. You have to compensate to the government, then why you're not able to perform. So that has to be taken care of. And regarding improving efficiency of the plant, there are many ways. You use best quality of the product like module. DC side should be overloaded. Loaded, not overloaded, as per design specification. People are training 40%, 30%. But please see, your inverter also capable of overloading facilities. Don't keep on overloading. Then what happens? You're overloading a plant, but when peak generation comes between 11 to 3 p.m., 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., that time there's a limitation. It can't infuse more than the inverter capacity. So that time you're not able to infuse the generation. So keep optimum level of equipments with your plant. So at least return what you are expecting, and what is basic objective of the complete putting the plant, that is achieved. So with this, me, what we are growing, we should maintain this growth, we should sustain this growth, and some further we should grow. So these are all steps we should remember always. Thank you very much.